Hello aspirants, welcome to Current Affairs for Beginners session by La Excellence. This session will help beginners in reading the Hindu newspaper. Let me give you answers for yesterday's questions. The first question is, consider the following pairs. It is given the military exercise name and the country which is participating in that military exercise. The first one is Maitri. It's between India and Thailand. This is the correct one. And the second one is Yudh Abhyas. This is between India and United States and not China. So this is wrong one. And the third one is Surya Kiran. This is between India and Nepal. This is the correct one. So the correct one are 1 and 3. So the option is B. The second question is, NABARD is a member of the Alliance for Financial Inclusion. The statement is correct. And the second statement is, it serves as an apex financing agency for the institutions providing investment and production credit for promoting the various development activities in the rural areas. The statement is also correct. This is the apex financing agency that will provide investment and production credit for the promotion of developmental activities in the rural areas. So both the statements are correct. The answer is C, both. Topics covered under today's core are interlinking of rivers. What is this concept and what are the advantages of this interlinking of rivers, and what are the environmental impacts of this interlinking of rivers, and what is this MP LAT scheme, and what is this National Crisis Management Committee, and what is this BIMSTEC? It is a regional grouping. And what is this agreement, free trade agreement, and what is this RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership? This is also a free trade agreement between 16 countries, and let us see what it is. And the seventh one is National Disaster Response Fund. River interlinking, Karnataka seeks rightful share in the water allocation. Here you have to know what is this interlinking of rivers and what are the disadvantages of this interlinking of rivers and what are the advantages of this and what is the idea of this interlinking of rivers. We have some rivers that are surplus and we have some rivers that are deficit, and you know, irrigation or agriculture or any for any domestic use, we mainly depend on rivers. So this idea is transferring of this river water. See, if there are surplus, there may be cause of some floods. So, if we can divert the river water which is surplus here to this river, then the area here, we can save these people from floods. We can give to this people the water for irrigation or for domestic use. This is the idea of interlinking of rivers. How to link? See, if there is river here and if there is river here, through canals and reservoirs, they will link and they will divert the river flow. This is called interlinking of rivers. And now the question is, how you can say the water in the river is surplus or deficit? For suppose, if in a river there is water for humans' requirement of, like, for irrigation, for domestic consumption and for industries, there is available water. And there is extra water apart from this requirement, then we call that river as river having surplus water. The deficit also we see the same way. That is, if the river is not satisfying the human needs, then we call that river with deficit water. And we have divided this river linking process into three components. That is, for northern Himalayan rivers, interlink component. For northern Himalayan rivers, that is Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, these rivers, we have Ganga, Brahmaputra river linking, Ganga, Yamuna river linking. That is, river linking between these two rivers or the tributaries of these two rivers. Second one is southern peninsular component. Here you can see the rivers like Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, and you have this river linking between Godavari and Mahanadi, and Godavari Krishna you have river linking. These will come under southern peninsular component. northern Himalayan rivers interlinking component, southern peninsular component, and the third one is intrastate rivers. That is, if there are two rivers within the state and river linking of these two, you'll call it as another component. Between two states, you have northern Himalayan and southern peninsular, and the third one is intrastate river linking component. And some of the examples of this river linking are Kane Betwa. Try to see where is this Kane River, Betwa River, and what is this river linking. These rivers are the tributaries of the major river, and see what is this major river. These are the tributaries of, and like that, see Godavari Maharadi river linking and Godavari Krishna river linking. Let us see what are the advantages of this river water linking. There will be majorly four advantages. The first one is the river flow. If the river flow is so good, we can generate power from that. Hydro power generation is the first benefit. And the second one is groundwater recharging. There will be improvement in the groundwater level if there is this type of river linkings. And the third one is irrigation to these areas that are linked. See, if the river is here and the other river is here, this is linked here, these areas will be most benefited. And the irrigation in this area can also develop. And the next benefit is aquatic ecosystems. If there is continuous river flow, then there is a chance of increasing in the aquatic ecosystems. And you also have environmental impacts with this river linking. The first one is ecological imbalance. That is, there are different ecological systems. See, this river may have one ecosystem and this river may have another ecosystem. There will be different type of species, and here this will be different. If this was linked, there may be creation of ecological imbalance because of the variation in the hydrological regimes. That is, this river frequency, duration or length, breadth, there may be change. This river frequency also, that is flow of water, may change. According to the flow of this water, there will be organisms in that river. But now, everything will be changed. Ecological imbalance is the first environmental impact. And the second, this will erode the coast. See, here there may be, in this area, there may not be river. To link this, this coast will be, or this area may be eroded. And here, this should be displaced. Displacement is the another problem. The people here, you should vacate these people because this river should be linked. And river normally is going to the sea in this way. Now, you are changing the course of the river. Changing the course of the river away from the sea may cause other impacts. In order to create canals and reservoirs, mass deforestation can take place. And due to this interlinking of rivers, there will be decrease in the amount of fresh water entering seas. This will cause a serious threat to the marine life system. This will be a major ecological disaster. And the next impact is, every river has its own quality. See, if you are mixing two rivers, this will be so pure or less polluted, this will be more polluted. And now if you river link these two rivers, then both the rivers have the chance of pollution, or this may not be useful for drinking facilities or any domestic use facilities. These are the impacts of this river linking. And now government have to see all this and then have to plan a strategy such that these impacts should be go down. Use MP Lads funds to contribute. MP stole. What is this MP Lads? This is Member of Parliament Local Area Development Scheme. In the name only you can see, this is MP Local Area Development Scheme. This is the scheme to develop local area of an MP. That is, how we elect MPs? In the state, we divide state into constituencies, and every constituency will elect MP directly. And this MP under this scheme can recommend the developmental activities in some social areas. What are the social areas? Like any improvement needed in the health of that area, or education-wise improvement, or drinking water facility improvement, or improvement in the electricity, or family welfare, or any sanitary-related improvements like roads or drainages, any construction activities. He can recommend the district authorities to develop these under this scheme. And this is a centrally sponsored scheme. This is fully funded by the government of India. And under this scheme, the funds will be released in the form of grants in aid directly to the district authority. And how much fund? 5 crore every year will be released. And these funds are non-lapsable. That is, this year 5 crore is released. But in this constituency, only 3 crore was spent. And the remaining 2 crore plus the 5 crore of, that is 2 crore plus 5 crore of the next year will be spent on the next year. That is, for next year, there will be availability of 7 crore. Non-lapsable. That is, it will not lapse then and there. That is, for that year, it will not lapse. It will transfer to the next year. So we call that fund as non-lapsable fund. Remember, the role of the MPs in this is only recommendatory, and they can recommend their choice of works, that is, whether this work related to health should be taken first, or education taken first, or drinking water facility work should be taken first. Like that, MP will recommend, and they can recommend to the district authorities. The next article is NDRF aid only for several calamities. This article is important because up to now we have seen many times about this National Disaster Management Act 2005, and what is this National Disaster Response Force and this National Disaster Response Fund and State Disaster Response Fund. These all the bodies constituted under this act we have seen already. But here we have to see this National Disaster Management Policy. Under this, it was saying it was the responsibility of state governments to provide disaster relief from their respective state disaster response funds. And from where these funds are collected, here it was given. This SDRF is contributed by the union government and the respective state governments in the 75:25 ratio. That is, SDRF fund, 75% central government will give, and 25% of the fund will be contributed by the state government. And this is for normal states. And for special category states, we have some special category states. And for that, the ratio is 90:10. And what is this NDRF, that is National Disaster Relief Fund, when this will be given? This will be given, here it was also mentioned that for a calamity of severe nature, that is, if there is any disaster that is so heavy, we call that as calamity of severe nature. And for that, there will be National Disaster Response Fund will be given. And how this NDRF will get the funds? That is, NDRF is funded through a National Calamity Contingency Duty. That is, the government will levy the duty on the persons who use this pan masalas, tobacco, cigarettes. On them, extra duty will be allowed by the government, and that duty, it is like extra money or extra tax, you can say, that we call as National Calamity Contingency Duty. And this duty will fund the NDRF. And along with this National Calamity Contingency Duty, there will be some budgetary allocations. That is, on budget, they will take some amount for this type of calamities. And along with that, any person can give or can contribute to this NDRF. That is, NDRF will get funds through three ways. Any institution can fund them, or it was funded through National Calamity Contingency Duty, or through budgetary provisions, NDRF will be funded. And SDRF, as I said, center, state, 75-25 in case of normal, that is general category states, 90-10 in case of special category states. And this SDRF, I said, central will give 75 in case of general or 90 in case of special category states. And this will be released in two installments, that is June and in December. And this remaining part is about the center, how much allocated to particular state under SDRF or NDRF, how much is allocated by the center to the states. So here you should know what is this NDRF, what is this SDRF, how this differs, and what is the fund share for the SDRF, and how SDRF and NDRF will get the funds. The next article is, it is calamity of severe nature. Here already you have know much about this Kerala floods, and this was declared as calamity of severe nature for all practical purposes. Whenever a disaster or any calamity is declared as calamity of severe nature, then center will give or contribute this National Disaster Response Fund to the state. And here you have to see this committee, National Crisis Management Committee. Whenever there is any natural calamity, we have all this National Disaster Management Authorities and NDRF funds, state funds, SDRF, everything we have. But to effectively implement any relief measures, whenever there is any natural calamity, then Cabinet may set up a committee, and this committee we call as National Crisis Management Committee. Remember, Cabinet may set up this committee or may not set up this committee. So whenever there will be any prelims questions like National Crisis Management Committee is a permanent committee, that is permanent cabinet committee, then this is wrong statement. And this topic you can read under GS Paper 3, Disaster Management. And now, if this cabinet formed or set up this committee, then Agricultural Secretary will give all the related information to this committee to do or to take any steps for the effective implementation. And whenever this committee was not set up, then all the matters relating to the relief shall be reported to the Cabinet Secretary. That is, if there is any committee set up, then this National Crisis Management Committee will take care of all the relief measures. If there is no committee set up, then Cabinet Secretary will do the things. What this committee do, this will recommend the relief measures to the crisis management group, and this crisis management group will implement it. And this crisis management group will meet at least twice a year in the months of December or in the months of, that is May, June, one time it will meet, and December, January, another time it will meet. And then this crisis management group will review every year all the contingency plans that are formulated by the central ministries and departments. This will review the measures that are required for dealing with the natural calamity. How to deal with the natural calamity, there will be some measures. This group will review all the measures, and this will coordinate the activities of the central ministries and the state governments in relation to the disaster preparedness and relief, and this will obtain the information from the nodal officers on measures relating to the all the above said these measures. This group will mainly coordinate between the ministries and departments and review all the measures that to be taken before a natural calamity. BIMSTEC envoys BAT for free trade agreement. Here you have to see many words. The first one is, what is this BIMSTEC? And the second one is, what is this free trade agreement? And here, you have to concentrate on many regional groupings like ASEAN, SAARC, SASEC. Firstly, this article is about the next summit that is going to held in Kathmandu on August 30 and 31, and Modi, our Prime Minister, will attend that summit of leaders of the group. These BIMSTEC countries, they want to sign this free trade agreement, but they are suffering from some problems. So this article is discussing about that, and we have to concentrate all these international organizations. The first one, let me say, what is this free trade agreement? Before that, there are two countries. Let us see this example. There are two countries, and between these two countries, trade, what we say trade, like imports and exports, basically imports and exports. This country is sending the goods to this country, then this will be imports for this country. And if this country is sending the goods to this country A, let's say B, this will be exports, and this will be exports of this country, imports, vice versa. And to send goods from one country to other country, you'll have some quotas, tariffs on that goods. What is this quota? See, if there are some goods, say you have clothing, that is textiles, you have to send this amount of textiles only. This will be quota. You have to import this amount of textiles only. This will be quota. This quotas will be restricted on the trade. And tariffs, like on this amount of textiles, you'll be having this percent of tax. We call for outer countries as tariffs. So whenever there will be trading of goods between the countries, there will be quotas and tariffs. And to reduce these quotas and tariff barriers, we will have an agreement, and we call that agreement as free trade agreement. Free trade agreement is an agreement between at least two countries to reduce trade barriers, that is quotas and tariffs, and to increase the trade between goods and services between these two countries. This can be two countries or more than two countries, but at least two countries is needed. And here you can see this BIMSTEC, ASEAN, SAARC and SASEC. These four are regional groupings. That is, in region, there will be some countries. These countries will form as a group. We call that as regional grouping. And this topic is in our UPSC GS Mains 2. And under IR, International Relations, you have some regional groupings and their mandate. Under this topic, you can study this article. And let us see, what is this Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Grouping, that is BIMSTEC. This is an international organization of seven nations of South Asia and Southeast Asia. See, for any organization, now BIMSTEC, this is seven country organization. And here you have SAARC, this is eight country organization. And you have ASEAN, this is 10 country organization. And SASEC is 7 country organization. For all this, you have to see how many countries and what are the countries and what are the aims of this organizations. For example, for BIMSTEC, by the name you can see the countries: Bangladesh, India, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Thailand, here Bhutan and Nepal. These are the seven countries. And for SAARC, if you can see the map, India and the countries that are surrounding India are the member countries of this SAARC association. The names are just South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. This we have discussed many times. And what are the countries here? India. And this side you have Afghanistan and Pakistan to the west, Bangladesh to the east, Nepal and Bhutan to the north, Sri Lanka and Maldives to the south. Eight countries and ASEAN. This is Association of Southeast Asian Nation. This will start from Myanmar, and Myanmar, Thailand, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, and Brunei, and Philippines. These 10 countries are the members of ASEAN. in the next organization is CISEC, South Asian Sub-Regional Economic Cooperation, and the countries are India, Nepal, Bhutan, as I've said, to the north, Sri Lanka, Maldives to the south, and Myanmar and Bangladesh to the east. Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Maldives to the south, Bangladesh and Myanmar to the east. And all these groupings are mainly regional cooperation, that is mainly for regional cooperation, economic cooperation, and sometimes political cooperation. All these groupings are to build a better quality of life for the people in these regions. And please try to see the maps of these organizations and objectives related. Stay with RCEP. Here you have to see what is this RCEP. This is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. This is a proposed free trade agreement between 10 member countries of ASEAN countries, and 3 countries, that is China, Japan and South Korea, and 3 more countries, India, New Zealand and Australia. These 16 countries was about to have an agreement of free trade. That is, between 2 countries, there will be decrease in the barriers, increase in the goods and services trade. Between these countries, there should be free trade agreement, and we call that free trade agreement about to sign as RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. And this was formally launched in 2012 in Asian Summit, and this is expected to sign in this November 2018 in Singapore Summit. But there are some problems signing this agreement for India, and these problems or the issues while signing this project are discussed in this article. Try to answer these questions. The first question is about MP LAT scheme. It is a centrally sponsored scheme. And the second question is, funds released under this scheme are lapsable. The second question is about Cane River. Cane River is the tributary of River Ganga, and this is the one of the major rivers that flows through Bundelkhand region. Try to answer these questions, and the detailed explanations of these question answers will be available for you in the next video, and you can download the notes of this core video at www.laics.in/civilsprep. Thank you.